drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot.
Call me Cardi B, I run this shit like cardio.
My God.
What's up, everybody? It's your boy Saki, and if it's something to be thankful for, is the fact that I got my own YouTube channel coming out by the end of this month called What the Saki. Yeah, dance to it. Ooh, What the Saki. Ooh, look, it's gonna be nothing but fun. Tune in, subscribe. That's what I'm thankful for. Peace.
Okay, so we want to give a shout to What the Saki.
Hey!
Good luck to you, and thank you for sharing your good news. Hello, October. We are going to start off this week and this new month with a motivational word, okay? October is about trees revealing colors they've hidden all year. People have an October as well. Some words to think about from the Instagram famous poet, J.M. Storm. I don't know if you follow him, but he always is dropping knowledge.
I love
that. And
it's
poetic. And he actually has a book out now because he's become so popular. But I just thought that was perfect because I think that when we start a new month, instead of looking back and being like, oh my gosh, where did September go? It is a perfect time. And we do that. I'm at fault. And so I always have to be reminded. And it's things like this that remind me, hey, this is time to wipe the slate clean, right?
Yes.
Look at a new month, find a way to own October. And with those words I just read to you, I just want you to start thinking, what are you hiding? What color leaves are you hiding? In other words, what hidden talent, what hidden voice, hidden project, hidden passion is just sitting there that's bubbling, you know, closer to the top and that the world needs to see. And what are you going to do starting today to get one step closer to achieving that and to sharing that with everybody? Because we all know what you see here is what you get, but there's still so much more inside. You know, I'm always quick to say, don't judge a book by its cover, because there's a really good story in here. And I overuse that expression because I feel like so many of us, if you really just start talking to your coworkers, your friends, your family members, you will discover just all the layers that one human beholds. And you'll find that a lot of times you have more in common than you think.
I love that, Ange. Listen to that inner voice. New month, new blessings.
Uh-huh. So now that we warmed you up,
poof,
yes, with some good thoughts, a quick shout out to DC Magazine. This is the only time I will share Angie Goff. You see that? It's like in a size 8 font.
But you made it on the front page.
Angie Goff and Laura Dern.
Love her.
Sharing the cover. But let's, I'm actually on the very last page.
No, that's the best part. Tell them about this. The Goth Complex is in full effect.
Yes. So this is, DC Magazine does this thing every month called Look Who's Talking.
Who is your favorite designer for sporting on screen, aka on camera? Angie goes, which is so true. I wear a lot of Kate Spade. The cuts and prints are always fun and sometimes quirky. I love clothes that tell a story. Recently, I got a dress with a bunch of matches on it. Who
Fire!
Knew?
Fire!
Literally!
Get your edition of DC Magazine now if you can. It's the September issue. And thank you so much.
Yes.
Meanwhile, you know, we talked about peeling back the layers. When we went to that party, I decided to break out a new look. Is that Angie?
Hey!
No, it's the Asian Anta Wintour.
It's a new exotic look.
Yeah, right? So I walk down the stairs. I literally get off the air, my 7 o'clock show.
Yep.
I change in the telephone booth because I know I got to race to this party. I walk down the stairs and everyone looks at me like, and Blake is the first one to catch me on the stairs. You saw the video here. He's like, oh my God. He's like, she bought these bangs on Amazon. Yeah, so for $19.99, you just clip them on and it gives you a whole different look. And then you don't have to change it because in television, I can't just go and cut my hair when I want to. You know, there has to be a little level of consistency. And so it was really fun and I wore them out. And then everybody else wore them too that night because we decided to take them off and had a field day. I mean, there was guys wearing them, girls wearing them. I mean, it was so much fun. I ended up actually buying a bunch of more headpieces because that's the power of Amazon. You buy one set of fake bangs, and then all of a sudden, this showed up, and now I have like a Korean man's wig. I have two, they're like scrunchies, but they're hair, so they can make your bun look extra hairy.
Oh my God, reminds me of the Spice Girl days. Yes. I used to have a few of those. But the bangs looked real. They
right?
really did.
Yes,
so.
Do you like them? If you're on Facebook right now, please vote.
Bangs or no bangs?
Or no bang. Bang or no bang. Bang or no bang? Speaking of transforming into other people, Halloween is stressing me out. Halloween is stressing me out.
And it just, October just began.
I love costumes. I mean, we said it here. What's my biggest like? Costumes. What's my biggest dislike? People who leave their damn shopping carts inside the parking lot. Okay, stop being lazy, people.
Angie is on fire!
But back to the Halloween, you know we love family costumes.
Yes, you do.
And usually by now, I already know exactly what we're going to be.
Yep.
I already have started using the glue gun. I already have this planned. Last year, we did the royal wedding. The year before, I was impregnated. And so...
Yes, she was Mother Goose.
With a three-year-old child. One. I looked like I was about to hatch. But I... Yeah, so we did that. And remember, Robert was a goose and he was so big.
Yes!
That... When people took pictures of the family, like his head was cut off in every picture.
God bless Robert. I mean, he literally just goes with Angie's crazy ideas.
I should have brought the goose head. We've got to work the goose head into the show here at one
point. Well, we might have a costume every week during October, so stay tuned.
So anyways, if you have a good family costume idea, don't send me The Incredibles. Already done it.
Yeah, she did at Disney World.
No, and not only did I do The Incredibles, I like actually took it Incredibles 2.0. I actually did The Incredibles 2 costume. If you look at all the other incredible families out there, yes.
They weren't as incredible as
this one. No, they were not. Case in point, look at this. Red. Everybody's in the right seat. No, mine's gray. Okay? Because she was the hero in Incredibles 2. And it took 6 months for this to get to me from China. But I might have lead poisoning, but
she got it and she rocked it.
So do not send me the Incredibles. I'm not, no. Been there, done that. Candy Wars. We talked about this.
Yes.
I meant to bring in a bunch of candy, but I forgot. Sorry. So, Adam, can you just embellish? Give us some candy. Give us some candy.
He will.
Okay. Look at all this candy.
Yum!
Oh!
This is probably better for us anyways. Who needs the sweets?
Yes. Oh, gosh. CGI. Oh, I don't even know if that's what it's called. But, yes, the power
After
of...
After Effects.
The power of editor Adam Eazy-E Epstein. Okay, so... This new study, there's two studies, and it always comes out around this year. And we're talking about this over at Fox, and I did a whole report on it. And they do state by state what is the most popular candy.
Yes.
I think this thing is a fraud.
Probably.
In Maryland, the number one candy, they said, is Milk Duds.
You Ew. Got,
really?
I mean, I haven't had those since, like, third grade.
No, yeah, right? And I
lived in Maryland at that time.
I get Reese's Pieces being number one, I think, in D.C.
Love Reese's Pieces.
And I think M&M's in Virginia.
Okay. Really?
Yeah, I mean, surprise. I like M&M's. And then overall, the number one candy, I want to say, they said was Reese's for one study. And then the second study said Skittles.
Mm.
You know my favorite candy.
Yeah, I do.
It Oh Honey.
It literally is her favorite, and I am too young to even get the hype when she was growing up. So I'm like, what
the
is
hype?
Bit Oh Honey?
I was not born in 1952.
But it doesn't matter. She brought in like three packages of Bit Oh Honey back at her old stomping grounds just for all of us to
and
try.
And Brittany's reaction is like, I don't want to break my tooth. I don't want to break my tooth.
She's like, Bit Oh Honey.
And it's so good. Yes. And so I everybody at work said if I bring in Bit Oh Honey, they will all try it.
We never, Bit Oh Honey has never been a thing. Ever. When I was growing up. I mean, you're not old, but I'm just saying. Like, it was like an 80s candy. By the time the 90s came out.
No, it wasn't. It's like a 1940s candy. A lot of this candy, Tootsie Roll.
Oh.
Listen.
Tootsie Roll's always been
popular.
Do you know what Bit Oh Honey is? Maddie's 22, though.
Because millennials never go to the gas station anymore.
Maddie's Gen Z. Isn't that crazy?
I know, Gen Z.
Yeah, you are, Maddie. You're not a millennial, Maddie.
96 is the cutoff. Thank you very much.
Oh, right. You're just a little younger than my brother. You're right. Damn it.
Yeah, and don't sleep on Mary Jane's.
Oh, yeah, Mary Jane's. Yes, that's right.
Mary Jane's.
Rob, who's doing audio, says his favorite is Good and Plenty. You do like those? Good and Plenty. Remember those?
Clearly we're going off on a tangent.
They're like a poor man's Tic Tac. In case you missed it, Brittany.
And when October goes, the snow begins to fly above the smoky roofs. I watch the planes go by. The children
okay, so I know I just said, hey, embrace October. But this whole show is a contradiction. And we are hypocrites, you know, when it comes to everything. So
live in the stream.
The reality is that October's here, which means the snow, you know, when October's gone, what's going to happen? And our buddy Kevin Williams, I recently saw this week, he posted this and I could hear the rage. What we're looking at here, folks, is his experience in Macy's recently, where there's a whole Christmas section.
Already?
Too soon?
Very much so.
Really? You're one of those.
But that is crazy because what time do you usually buy?
This was in September. Yeah, well, so this was because it was last week. So.
What time do you usually buy Christmas decorations?
Probably around now, you know, depending on what the theme is. Last year was Harry Potter. We had a Harry Potter theme.
Wait, I really want to show this.
You want to show the Harry Potter theme?
Angie literally has a theme every Christmas. Here's a look. Every holiday, it's a theme. Like every, it's crazy, guys.
Yeah.
Guess you think she's kidding about the costume? She's not. She doesn't even tell me what the family costumes are. It's like, pop up, surprise.
Yeah, but we're moving this year, so that's why, like, kids are lucky if they even get costumes this year. They might just wear what they wore last year. Is Meghan Markle still, is Duchess Markle, are they still married? I don't think it's too early, and this is why. Not because I'm, like, a total, like, Christmas lover. I love commercialism. I buy into all of that. It's because I feel like this is a perfect way that we can avoid stress down the line.
True.
Go ahead. Yeah, you might have to pay full price, whatever, but buy your stuff now so we don't have to hear you later. Okay? Because everybody's holiday stress, and I work in news, so it's like, avoid the holiday stress. 5 tips so that you don't lose your mind. 5 tips so you can actually be present and enjoy the holidays and the Christmas cookies and the snow and the garland. And yeah. And I just realized, oh my gosh. So all these people that are bitching are the same people that are like mad that we just were racing, you know, to the holiday. No, get your stuff done now.
Organize.
Go buy it. Buy your gifts. Build your Amazon wish list for everybody. And then have it done before Black Friday even hits. Okay? Because you're really not going to save that much. Everybody is doing sales now ahead of time anyways. You know, that's the trend. That's where it's been going.
Angie. Keep it 100. I know. You definitely are.
I should be this week's awakening because I had a revelation, facts. People.
I wanted freedom. And I didn't want to be defined by anyone else's version of what my life looked like.
That is just one of the inspiring women as seen at the Rebelle Conference, or Rebelle Con as it's known. And joining us now in studio is the founder of Rebelle, Shannon Siriano Greenwood. Thank you so much for coming by.
Thank you for having me.
When I learned about this, I was like, I have to have you on because you are everything that we're about here on the Oh My Goff Show when it comes to not only women helping women, but just people helping people, and also finding ways to be successful. You know, that we grow up and we think that success is just like reaching these benchmarks in our career. And it's taken me so many years, almost like 16, 17 years being in the business I've been in, to realize, oh my gosh, no. Like for me, I've realized success is choices, like having choices to say no, choices to be with the family. And so in everybody, it's different. And that's what I loved about your mission statement. So when we talk about Rebelle and Rebelle Con, what is at the core of what you're doing?
Core is exactly that, for people to be able to define their own version of success, because success is different for everyone. But there are certain milestones, certain things that we think we have to check off, and we have to get to the next place and the next place and the next place. And not until oftentimes you get all the way there and then look back and realize that wasn't really what I wanted. Those are the things I thought I should have. So we want to have the conversations as early as possible to tell people, hey, you don't have to strive or achieve what other people have achieved to be successful. Once you define it for yourself, you can do whatever you want.
A lot of times these ideas come from personal experience, and boy, do you have one.
I do, yes. Mm-hmm. I am a recovering workaholic, recovering striveaholic, right? Mm-hmm. I was a really good student. I always did what people asked of me. So I thought achieving my way to happiness was how I was going to get there, right? And I had my personal experience with burnout and postpartum depression that really like shone the light on what was going on. I think had I not had that experience, I think I'd still be striving my way to something. I don't know what that would be. So once I had my own experience with depression, I really had to reevaluate what was important to me. And I was having these kinds of conversations with other women who were also kind of in that same space, maybe not to the point of depression and burnout that I was, but were also in a place in their career, in their life, that they were kind of questioning everything of what really am I working so hard for?
It's like do everything and anything you're asked for. Go hard, you know, play hard, work hard, or go home. And you are here to dismount that idea.
Well, burnout is a big thing, and people really don't understand how detrimental that is to you physically, mentally, emotionally. And it's something that's very easy, especially for those like good student types, which so many of us are. And I think it also really affects your creativity and your problem solving. When you're just striving and working and getting to the next goal and getting to the next goal, you're not taking the time to really step back and be creative and look for the solutions that are going to be sustainable long term. You're just headed for that next milestone.
Yeah, yeah. You're always just looking for the next garden. As Tamron Hall once told me, you know, you're not stopping to smell the roses and actually be present. You knew that there had to be a better way. You were so burned out. You were so worn out. You were like, what am I doing this for? You knew that there had to be a better way to reach that success. So what have you found has worked?
I think self-care is a big buzzword right now, and yeah, everyone has their own definition of what that is. For me, the biggest form of self-care is support. The people around you and the people that you spend your time with are so important, and we don't really often, other than our spouses, think about that super intentionally. But the people you're spending the most time with are the people that will affect you most. And if you're in an environment where you're not spending time with people that are really lifting you up and cheering mm-hmm. you on, that's a problem.
And this is really what Rebelle Con is all about, right? Tell me about the lineup for this year, because this is a whole weekend.
It's a whole weekend. It's 3 days. I'm so excited. So we have four themes that we address with our program: wellness, money, community, creativity. In our wellness segment, we have this amazing author. Her name is Miranda Anderson. She just wrote this book called More Than Enough. And the whole like theme underneath of it is that you don't need more stuff. That a lot of people use the accumulation of stuff to kind of numb and distract from their actual problems. We have Deanne Ivory. She's absolutely amazing. She's the creative director of Black Girl in Ohm. She's coming from Chicago, and she's going to talk about her career journey and just the incredible doors that have been opening for Black women in the wellness space.
Just can't create all day, every day. It's like impossible. So, I mean, I hope everybody does that and also knows that it's okay to do that, because you can be successful and not like overwork.
You actually have had a sibling that has spoke at Rebelle. Now, is he coming back this year? I know he's been very busy.
So I like never will say that he's coming, because you just never know with him and his schedule, but he'll make like surprise guest appearances. So you just have to come to every event if you want to see him, because that's the best way for me to to make sure I don't overpromise on his behalf. But yeah, he's been such a great. So my brother Christian Siriano.
We're talking, and you might have got it from her name when I introduced. And you guys have the same mannerisms. I mean, you guys kind of.
No, it freaks people out.
Yeah,
sometimes.
It does. And so we had to point out. So yes, so Christian is your brother,
and
a big supporter.
He's been a support literally since day one. And I mean, saying that his schedule is so busy. The first time I had this idea for the conference, I called him and I was like, I know you're really busy and I know you can't commit to things, but I'd really like for you to come and speak. And he was like, sure, what's the date? I'll be there. We have kind of the same mission. We're just going about it in very different ways, right? Like he's really shining the light on the lack of diversity and representation in the fashion space. And I'm kind of doing it in this like career and women's space. And so it's cool that we get to work together on things.
What is some of the best advice that you've gotten from your brother?
I don't.
No advice from him.
No. He is my little brother.
Oh, really?
Okay, no.
Oh.
I don't take advice from him.
You give him advice.
That's right. That's right.
What's the best advice you gave him?
He also probably would not accept advice from me or anyone. You know, I think it's really funny, the brother-sister dynamic.
He could be like one of the top designers in the world, and she's like, I will shut you down.
No.
Okay?
No. I am your older sister, and you will listen to me. No.
I love that. But I've seen some of his stuff online at Rebelle, and he is really inspiring and good.
Totally, he is.
Are there any key takeaways or anything that he said that resonated, you think?
Well, I mean, it's funny to say his big thing is he doesn't take advice from people because what he's doing hasn't really been done before. So people that want to give him advice are people that know how things have worked in the past. And he's not about what things have worked in the past. He's about what's going to work in the future. And so I definitely am inspired by that and him doing that.
So he's like a disruptor. He's like an original.
No question. But also it's just like he's like real stubborn and doesn't want to listen to people.
Has he been like that his whole life?
His whole life.
You were just together in Paris.
It was amazing.
We're looking at pictures right now. You in Paris.
I mean, people should be jealous of me. That was crazy. Yeah,
we should be jealous of you. And this, because this was huge. He showed his whole line.
He showed for the first time at Paris Fashion Week. And so I was so proud that I got to be there and experience it. It was absolutely stunning. I mean, just the whole, like, Paris is so iconic. And so everything was so beautiful and French. And then there he is, this like bold American designer. So like the juxtaposition of like the old, like French, like classic and like this new like energy. Oh, so cool. And it was like 4 days away.
Were
from
the French
babies.
People like hooty-snooty?
No, not at all.
Really?
I think everyone's really excited that it's something so new.
Well, I want this like seafoam dress.
No, I like want
did
every
you see
single
the
dress.
Seafoam? Like, I mean, that thing was immaculate. It's like art. I mean, he creates art.
And it's so insane.
And, you know, you go out to support his things and he comes out and supports what's important to you
as well.
I mean,
that's what it's about, right?
It really is. So going forward, what is going to be new? Because I know this is the fifth year or the fifth conference.
So we picked women from all different industries to come and do like an ask her anything session. So literally there's super successful women in different, you know, different spaces. We have a award-winning chef and restaurateur. We have an executive from a local company. We have the CFO of this really great e-commerce brand that's based in New York and Richmond. And literally you get to sit in a small group with her and ask her whatever you want.
When I was looking at past conferences is the diversity that you have. I mean, you see all walks of life there. I mean, the opening line was a woman holding a baby and speaking.
If you have an infant, you can bring like a mom or a friend to like hold your baby for free, because being a new mom should not prevent you from being able to work on yourself and find a supportive community. I was had a 3-month-old when we started.
Was that good for you, though, to jump into something?
Yes. So the first round of when I had my first son was when I really struggled with postpartum. And I think a big part of that was the isolation. But with my second baby, I was like, I'm doing this differently, right? I'm going to give myself a little space to go into the world. I'm going to try not to commit to anything that's too intense, which I didn't do that part very well. But if I'm going to do anything, I'm going to do it with people who get it, that like, no, I'm going to be breastfeeding my baby at our meeting. And like, no, if he really starts to cry, like, I'm just going to step away. And I don't care if we're in a meeting with like a huge sponsor or a speaker that we really need, like, I got to go if I got to go. And so doing it that way, not only did I feel like was more supportive to me, but a better example that I want to set for other mothers, that it doesn't have to be totally on or totally off. Like, you do it your way. And if you're with the right people, they'll get it.
What is the best advice you've ever gotten?
Best advice that I've ever gotten is just do you, right? You have to be true to you. And sometimes that takes time to figure out what that is.
What's your biggest regret?
Working too hard, right? Just working without a real goal in mind. So never do that again.
Well, Shannon Siriano Greenwood, thank you so much for stopping by. What you've put together is really an incredible thing. So if they want more information, where can they go for that?
RebelleCon.com, and Rebelle is spelled R-E-B-E-L-L-E. So RebelleCon.com, all the ticket information, all our speaker information, and information about the Rebelle community is all there.
And we hope that you'll come back.
Absolutely. Thank you for doing this.
O'Run.
I'm going to have to change my Instagram to Mother of O'Run. Mother of all dragons, okay? Mother of O'Run. Because let me tell you, I keep getting direct messages. These are everyday people, normal moms, and they're like, I just have to tell you that when there's a story in the IG, which is a day, without an O'Run, it makes me sad or it disappoints me. Or, hey, congratulations, really happy about your job and your success and glad you're soon to do well, but can we see more run? Recently, this past week, one of the comments, I posted a picture of me and Robert at an event that we went to, date night, and it was like, it's the parents of Oren. It's the mom and dad of Oren. No. And so so I would be remiss not to get some Oren in here. And actually, this kind of blew my mind. I was trying to convince her that it was time to take a nap. Mm-hmm. She has become a total rebel. Okay, so we need to go take a nap. Look at me. You ready to go take your nap?
No.
You have to go night-night. No. What if I get you milk? You want milk?
No.
Come here. Come back now. Ren. One. Two. Three. Did she just say four? Did she say four?
Miss Sassy Pants. This is what's so cool.
And the youngest, pants.
Right. The youngest children always pick up things the fastest. I mean, the fact that she's already counting and finishing your sentence.
So she's in the background and I'm actually showing the video to Adora and Bob. I'm like, you got to see this. I think she said four. So they're watching. They're like, yeah, she did. And they were like, she said four. And then we hear in the background, five, six. And we were like, oh my God. And I go,
genius child.
And I'm looking at Adora and Bob. I'm like, did you teach her how to count? Did you teach her? You know, I didn't teach her how to count. I mean, I'm the mom and all, but like, I didn't teach her how to count. And so we don't know. And then Adora's like, I think she just knows it. And I'm like, okay. So thanks everybody for hanging out with us.
Yes.
As we get ready to kick off a new month.
Yes. And shout out to week. Shannon for stopping by. Yes. She was dope.
Yes. And remember, I mean, she's got people flying in from Chicago for this thing. So mm-hmm. head out to Rebelle Con. And remember the Greek festival also going on this week in the Northern Virginia area. I want to give a shout out to them as well over at St. Catharines.
Philotimo.
That's right. See, we're learning things.
So don't forget to share us your good news. All you got to do is just take a video, 10 seconds, and send it to info@ohmygoth.com. And we promise we will share it on the show.
Yes. And remember our favorite things at ohmygoth.com, too. If you see something around here, most likely it's one of our favorite things. And it's on the website. And that's where you can find it. All right. It's been real. It's been fun. Sing us out, Dolly. Rob, is this the hustle part?
Yeah, buddy. Okay.